One man is dead tonight after a home invasion and attempted robbery. It happened in the 8400 block of South 30th Circle in Fort Smith at about 7:30 last night. Now, only 4029 was at the scene as detectives worked the case. 4029's Kelly Johnson talked to police, who today released the name of the intruder who was shot and killed.
Preliminary investigation suggests that maybe it was a justified shooting or in self-defense.
Detectives on scene at the home at 8401 South 30th Circle say they believe the man that was shot and killed was attempting to rob the homeowners.
A man wearing a mask walked into this home and presented a gun.
That man has now been identified as 27-year-old Chad Cancel. The homeowner, 69-year-old James Kennell, told police that around 7:30 Friday night, Cancel got into the home through a front door, which was unlocked. Kennell told police Cancel fired a round of his semi-automatic handgun into the ceiling and then took him by gunpoint into the master bedroom, demanding prescription medication.
Obviously, just by the actions and by the reports that we got from the people inside, it seemed like there was some prior knowledge of once he entered the residence and knew where to go.
Police say Cancel left the bedroom to quiet Kennell's 5-year-old grandson, who was in the living room. That's when Kennell pulled a gun of his own. He told police he fired 2 rounds at Cancel, hitting him in the upper torso. Police reports say Cancel ran through the home before collapsing in the doorway. He was pronounced dead at the scene.
Any homeowner, and even on your own self, you have a right to defend yourself against someone who is coming after you, and there's an imminent threat of serious physical injury or death.
Police say that Cancel's mother knew Mrs. Kennell, who was also in the home at the time of the shooting.
The true tragedy is that they had no idea who this was because of the mask at the time and didn't realize until the end, which kind of made this even more of a tragedy.
Police say the investigation is still ongoing. Kelly Johnson, 4029 News.
Thank you, Kelly. Cancel's body has been sent to the Arkansas State Crime Lab for an autopsy. At this time, no charges have been filed.